Hey guys, welcome to Ozzysero. Today I'm going to show you on how to migrate a NodeMCU from ESPEasy to ESPHome in Home Assistant. Okay, so first thing that we need to do is we need to install ESPHome add-on in Home Assistant. Let's log in to our Home Assistant. To go to the add-on, you need to go to these settings, and from there you can see there is add-ons. Click that, and at the bottom there is a button there, says add-on store. Click that. And on the top, there's a search bar. Type the ESPHome, and you should be able to see three versions there. One is dev for development, and the beta version. We don't want these two. We want this one here, ESPHome. Click that, and in my case, I already have this one installed in my Home Assistant, so I don't see any install button here. Instead, I get the uninstall. So in your case, just click the install, and that will install the ESPHome. And your screen should be look like this after you install, and then you have to click the start to start the ESPHome. Let's do that now. Once the ESPHome is started, the next thing you need to do is you're going to click the open web UI or the user interface, and you are now in the ESPHome user interface. And as you can see, I have an existing device in here, which is my aircon. Now the next thing that we need to do is we need to create a new device, and then we're going to download the binary. So let's click the new device. And from here, just click continue, and let's name our device here to Sprinkler 101. By the way, the one that I'm going to migrate is an existing NodeMCU that I'm using for my Sprinkler, and its existing name is Sprinkler 1. So this time I'm going to create Sprinkler 101 so that I don't get a conflict with the entity name in Home Assistant. Click next on the one, and from here to select your device type, NodeMCU is ESP8266, so I will going to select the ESP8266. Once you click that, it will going to add that device there, and from there you just need to go skip for time being. And as you can see, the Sprinkler 101 device is now added, but at the moment it is offline. So this is my Sprinkler 01. I'm gonna access to the GUI, and as you can see, it is currently has a ESPEasy mega firmware. And if I go back to my Sprinkler here, this is the one that we are working on, Sprinkler 1. So this is working at the moment, and I can hear the water outside. This is the one that we are going to migrate from ESPEasy to ESPHome. So let's go back to the add-ons, ESPHome, and open web user interface. We then now need to download the binary file. To do that, go to these three dots here and click install. And from here, how do you want to install Sprinkler 101.yaml on your device? You have to select the manual download, click that, and what version you want to download, just click the modern format, click that, and that will going to start to compile the binary, and once it's completed, it will download automatically. So it's now completed, and as you can see, I have now a Sprinkler 101.bin file downloaded to the computer. Show in folder, and as you can see, I got it here. Then we can close this. The next step is to upload the ESPHome binary to the NodeMCU through OTA or over the air or wirelessly. So let's log into our NodeMCU. So once you're in the NodeMCU user interface, you go to tools, and under firmware, click the load and browse, and point it to the Sprinkler 101.bin. Click open, and after that, just click update. And I get update success, and the device is now rebooting. And let's go back to the Home Assistant, and as you can see, the device is now online. To verify that, let's go to the logs, and we should be able to see what's happening there. So as you can see, there is a hostname Sprinkler 101, and it's connected to the Tiger Wi-Fi, and it has given the IP address of 192.168.88.37, and you can see the signal strength in there. So our NodeMCU is now running ESPHome. Now let's take a look at the status of our sprinkler, and as you can see, that is not working anymore, the sprinkler one, because it is not ESPEasy anymore, and this one is a MQTT switch, and it is not gonna work anymore. But the sprinkler 2 is still the same switch MQTT, so that will still work. Now let's go back to the add-ons. Now that we have our sprinkler 101 online, we can start to do some YAML programming for our NodeMCU pins. Because remember that this is a migration, so we have existing pins that is active at the moment that is used by our sprinkler. So we need to adapt that pins that's being used, and we need to program that in here. We need to declare it, so we don't need to do some recabling on our NodeMCU. I'm going to open first the config file of my home assistant to look at the existing pin that I use for the sprinkler 1, which is now 101. I'm gonna go to configuration and go to sprinkler 1 zone 1, this one here. So at the moment it's using GPIO 5, so let's start with zone 1, and it's using 5. I'm gonna minimize this one and put in here on the side. So I'm going to edit this. To make it easy for you, you just go to the ESP home and look for the GPIO switch, and you can just copy the sample configuration in there and paste it in here. So I have one already. I'm just gonna copy that, and from there you can change the pin, which is our existing sprinkler zone 1 is using GPIO 5, and we just need to copy this one here. And our zone 2 is GPIO 13. Zone 2. Our zone 3 is 12 zone 3. And our zone 4 is GPIO 14. And our last zone on our last stone is stone 5, GPIO 4. This one is stone 5. Okay, and after that, you just click save. We're just going to double check to make sure we're doing it right. Sprinkler 1, GPIO 5, sprinkler 2, 13, and that is zone 2, zone 3 is 12, and zone 4 is 14, and zone 5 is 04. So that is correct. Let's save that one, and after that you need to validate first to check if the YAML configuration is correct. And once you get the green tick box here, means that it's okay, then you have to click install. And it will ask you now, how do you want it to be installed in the Sprinkler 101? Because the device is now online, we can do it wirelessly. What it will do is, we're going to compile the YAML that we just created, and then it will upload wirelessly to the Sprinkler 101 device. By the way, if you are going to upload this one directly to your computer, or it's first time to flash that with ESPHome, obviously you need to plug into your computer. In that case, you need a USB driver for that one. I'm gonna put the link below for the driver for the NodeMCU. And now it seems that we get a success loading here. It says successfully compiled and then uploading 100% done. So we're just gonna wait until it will be connected to the wireless. At the moment it says there error resolving, but then now it's connected. So you have to look at on this one. When you can see the signal strength, it means that it's connected and you get the IP address as well. And that's it. Once you get that completed, you can click the stop. And that will close, and as you can see, your device is online. We can now then go to the settings, because the next step that we need to do is we're going to configure the discovered ESPHome integration in Home Assistant. As you can see, I got two notifications here, and it looks like there is a new discovered device or devices, and I dismissed this one. You can either go in here, notification checkout, or you can go to the settings and go to the device and services. And from here, there is a discover device, which is the sprinkler 101. All you have to do is configure that one, click the configure and submit, and you can put it, if you have area you can put in there. I will say probably put in here yard, add new yard, and just click finish. And if you look at the ESPHome integration here, you can see that we have two now. And if you click this sprinkler 101, see there is a device and there is an entity here. It's strange that it's only seeing one entity, so we're expecting to have at least maybe six entities here. That's alright, we can go to developers and go to the states and have a look if there's a new switch 101 created there. Switch 101, there you go. And as you can see, it's in there already. Switch sprinkler 101 zone 1, and the status is off, which is good. At least it's not unknown, because if it's unknown, it means that it's not detected. So that is up to 5, and we can actually test from here. That will turn on, which is it's on. I have checked back the integrations under ESPHome, and I can confirm that this is now has 6 entities. So probably it just took a while for the Home Assistant to update the information. Since the entity is already available, we can use it for programming. Let's go to the overview and go to our sprinkler, and at the moment the sprinkler 2 is running because I have the automation running at 6 o'clock. So I'm gonna edit this one, because I'm gonna change this zone 1 to 5 to the new one. So I'm gonna click edit, and I'm going to select sprinkler 101 zone 1, and this one here sprinkler 101 zone 2, oops, sprinkler 101 zone 3, sprinkler 101 zone 5, and save it. And looking at it, sprinkler 101 zone 3 is on, and I think because of this campy, that's okay. I'm just gonna turn this off and we'll leave that sprinkler 2 on. I'm gonna click done. So at the moment our sprinkler is already in there, and we can now control. I forgot I need to change the icon as well, same as this one. So let's just do that quickly. Zone 1, it's gonna click edit in the one, and then the MIDI icon, water pump, this one here, go back here, edit this zone 2, water pump 5. Is that zone 5, is it? We need a zone 101 zone 5. So here, water pump, and that's it. Done. Cool. There's one thing that I found out, guys. When I went outside, I found out that all the sprinklers or the zone 1 to 5, they are all turned on. Although in here they are all turned off, but it is actually turned on. I found out that the NodeMCU pins output, they are all active high. What it means is that the default value of the pins are all logic 1. Let me show you quickly what I mean. So let's log into our ESPEasy sprinkler 02. I cannot access the 101 anymore, as the web interface 101 is not enabled, and I don't think we can see that in there as well. So my sprinkler 02, which is still on ESPEasy, and let's go to the devices. And as you can see here, I have 3 GPIOs here for my zone 1, 2, 3. And there's a 1 value there. So at the moment, if you look at this one here, zone 1, 2, 3, they are off, but the value of the pin, they are all 1. So if I will going to turn on the zone 3, and if you refresh this one, you can see that it turns to 0. So it's inverted. And the turn on in the Home Assistant is giving a 0 pin output on the NodeMCU. Let's turn off this one first. So it will be confusing, because at the moment this zone 1 to 5 is on, but actually in Home Assistant it is turned off. So let's turn off this one, turn on this one, but actually in actual they are all turned off. And after that, we're going to program those pins. So basically we want these pins to be turned off by default, instead of having a logic 1. It says in here, if it's active low switch, we need to invert it. So we need to define inverted is equals to true. So to do that, let's go to the programming and just add a line here, add a line inverted here and say true. And let's just copy this one and add across to all the pins or GPIO. And once you got that inverted, just save it, and then we need to validate it When you got no error, then you can install it again and select wirelessly so that it will update the binary file with that new YAML inverted command. Now that is completed and it's trying to resolve the IP address. We're just gonna wait until it will connect to the wireless. Yep, there you go. It's now connected and we can click stop and verify that one. So we go to sprinkler. So the moment everything is on, so we have to turn this off. There you go. And I can hear it. It was turned off. So that fixed the issue. So this is now correct. And that's about it, guys. Thank you for watching. And if you are new to this channel, please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you on my next video.